me share with you a young man, also of African origin, of Abyssinian origin, who was born 46 years after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's migration to Medina Munawwara. I'm speaking of none other than Sa'id ibn Jubair.
This was a man who grew up with a love of knowledge that attached him to the greatest of the Sahaba. He was a student of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. He was a student of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. He was a student of Abu Huraira. And finally, he became one of the greatest students of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. This man who was a teacher of men and a maker of rijal. And he became one of the greatest of the Tabi'een and one of the most learned people of this Ummah. When he died, it was said about him, with him, knowledge has gone into the earth that every single living creature in this world is in need of. With this man's death, knowledge has gone into the earth that will not be returned.
Despite the fact that the Prophet ﷺ had passed away, the zeal of knowledge and the desire to acquire knowledge, this was paramount in the heart of this young man. It is said about him as a little child, there was only two things in his life. Either you found this lad sitting with a kitab and studying, or you found him sitting in the masjid and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He used to recite the Quran, the entire Quran by night. And there was a verse of the Quran, when he used to read this, it used to give him a shiver. إِذِ الْأَغْلَالُ فِي أَعْنَاقِهِمْ وَالسَّلَاسِلُ يُسْحَبُونَ فِي الْحَمِيمِ ثُمَّ فِي النَّارِ يُسْجَرُونَ. Allah says, when the disbelievers will be shackled and they will be hurled into the hellfire, and then they will be made to drink the hot fire and the hot water that will be burning. Wallahi, it is mentioned when he used to read this verse as a youngster, he used to sob so profusely that it used to make the elderly people around him cry. He initially was based in Iraq, in Kufa. But this was an era where Hajjaj, the notorious bloodshedder, had his dominance and his sovereignty. So this youngster decided, for the safety of his iman, because if I present in the court of Hajjaj, either it's my life or my religion, and both are dear both are an asset to me. So he then sneaks out of Basra and Kufa, and he takes amnesty in Makkah. And for 10 years, as a young man growing up, he disseminated the knowledge of deen. He had profound knowledge. He learned from the likes of Abdullah ibn Abbas, from Aisha radiallahu anha, and a host of other Sahaba.
And Hajjaj, when his governor found about the power and the authority that this man had amongst the people, he sent his armies to get this man. And his armies came, and when they took him from his house, his daughter began to weep, and she said, and he said, لِقَاؤُنَا فِي الْجَنَّةِ. Our meeting is in Jannah. So he knew where he was going. وَأَعْظَمُ جِهَادٍ كَرِمَةَ الْحَقَّ مَعَمْ سُلْطَانٍ جَائِرٍ. And the greatest jihad is to speak the truth in front of an unjust tyrant and then be killed for it. And this is the ahad which Sa'id ibn Jubair had.
When they apprehended him, he addressed his colleagues around him. Now this is a young man in the prime of his life, of African origin. What did he say? He said, Wallah, the way I look, my time is up and I'm going to die at the hands of this tyrant ruler. Then before they took him, he said, let me share something with you people. Myself and two of my companions very recently had spent a night exclusively in the worship of Allah. We will say we were on a hiking trip, we were on a swimming, we were on a fishing trip, we were hunting, whatever it was. We were on a night of ibadat. We initially thought we'll just spend 1-2 hours in ibadat. But before we got into the rhythm of ibadat, the next best thing, we felt an ecstasy in dua. Like you ask a youngster, he'll tell you, I just went and I went with my friend. I thought I'll pop one pill and I'll be back. Before I knew, I was popping pill after pill, woman after woman. The night was over and I didn't know where I was. How one sin leads to another, my brother? Wallah, one good leads to another. He said, we started the night of dua. فَاسْتَشْعَرْنَا حَلَاوَةَ الدُّعَى. Next best thing, we felt an ecstasy in dua. And we couldn't get ourselves off that worship mat. And each one of us just cried to Allah profusely. And we felt such a bond with Allah that we all echoed common duas and supplications. Allah, accept our life. The life of my two companions have been accepted. Baqitu ana antadhir. I'm the only youngster left behind. But I'm hopeful my dua has not been rejected. My time has also come. They then shackled him up. And listen to this. As they then escort him out, his little daughter, he was a young man, he had a small daughter. His little daughter ran out. Now can you imagine what a clash of emotions this was? To Today's young man, he abandons wrong, and one SMS from that girl, he feels emotionally obliged, and then he reverts to his wrong. This is a young man who is ready to present his life, preserve his iman. The emotion that is interrupted by is his little daughter. I don't have a daughter, I have a son, but I know when at times you're flying abroad for a program and just the sight of your child and the innocence of your child, knowing that you plan to return, yet you're looking at your daughter in her eye, there's no return. The people that had escorted him, merciless. He looks at his daughter and he's been escorted. So she breaks down emotionally. She clings onto her father and she started screaming and yelling. He keeps his composure, keeps his balance. This is a young man who has priorities in order. Very gently he motions away. He keeps his tears behind. Ya bunayyatu, quli li ummik. Oh my daughter, tell your mom. Tell your mom, isbiri, inna mawidana al-jannah. Tell her to persevere. I am going. I doubt I'll come back, my darling. But tell mommy, Allah will unite us in Jannah. Wallah, I am hopeful from Allah. If the young man of today, you don't have that clash of emotions, but I'm hopeful if you can put an end to haram and you can drop that DVDs and you can get rid of that music, I'm optimistic from my kind Allah. He will give you no less reward than that what he gave to Sa'id ibn Jubair. This young man was then brought into the court of Hajjaj ibn Yusuf.
And so he was brought forth in front of Hajjaj ibn Yusuf and he said, Man anta? And he said, Sa'id ibn Jubair. And he said, Bal anta Shaqi ibn Uksir. You're the Shaqi because Sa'id is felicitous. He said, you're the wretched, the son of the broken. Jubair is the one that fixes. And he said, my mother knew what my name meant more than you did. And then he asked him a series of questions.
Sa'id, I want to ask you, what's your opinion about me? We know how a man mellows down to truth when it is boss, when it is seniors, when he's seen a job to secure. Yeah, his life is on the line. His neck is on the line. You know yourself better. Why should I tell you about you? What must I tell you? Sa'id, I want to hear from you. What is your opinion about me? He said, if you want to hear, brace yourself for something unpleasant. I'm afraid you're not going to hear nice things about yourself. Now go for it. What is it? You openly violate the orders of Allah. You are a tyrant. You are a dictator. Which, ya Allahu Akbar. You openly violate the orders of Allah. Your only aim is to impress upon the people your fear, that they must fear you. And that's going to land you in problems and ultimately in hell. So Hajjaj said, you are provoking me and enraging me. I will kill you. The last arrow in a king's quiver is, I'll kill you. It's a dialogue. Now look at the words of this young man. My young brother, you can only talk like this if you don't talk to haram woman. Then this is the strength Allah will give you. He said, if you kill me, you will destroy my life in this world and I will destroy your life in akhirat. I will have no life in this world, but you will have no life in akhirat. Once upon a time, the youth of this ummah made this entire ummah proud. This was the legacy. Today we drop our gazes down out of embarrassment and humiliation looking at our youth. You go to any mall and see what our youngsters are doing. Hajjaj then tells him, اختر لنفسك أي شيء قتلت شئت. Sa'id, decide how do you want to die. Decide how you want to die. Sa'id said, can I rephrase that question? Let me ask you, Hajjaj, the manner in which you're going to kill me, that is how Allah is going to punish you. Let me rephrase this, how would you prefer being punished in Akhirah? Don't ask me, how do I wish to be killed? Let me rephrase it. Whatever you do to me, so will it be done to you. Decide how you like to be punished, and that is how you kill me. He said, okay, let's call it a close deal and I pardon you. He said, in kana afun fa min Allah. I don't fall for your temptations. If we conclude on pardon, it's the decree of my Allah. You've never pardoned me and you can never pardon me. As-sayfa wa nata'a ya ghulam. Bring the sword and drop the mat and kill this wicked man. So he smiles. He smiles. Hajjaj says, wama tabassumuk. One is that young man who smiles at a tyrant in his eye. That smile brings him close to Allah. One is the young man who has a smile flirting every woman. That smile only draws him closer to hell. What makes you smile, oh young man? He said, ajibtu min jara'atika ala Allah wa hilmi Allahi alayk. I'm smiling looking at your arrogance and Allah's kindness towards you. I'm just marveling at how the clemency of Allah, the grace of Allah. You are getting arrogant upon arrogant and Allah is just being calm and patient and displaying clemency with you. So he says, Uqtulhu ya ghulam, slaughter him. So he turns towards Qibla. Inni wajjahtu wajhiya lilladhi fatara as-samawat. Once upon a time, this is how the young man of this ummah died. Today my youngster is dying with a haram woman, with music blasting, going towards a club. Allah alone knows the destiny of this man. As he turns towards Qibla and he reads, Inni wajjahtu wajhiya lilladhi, I turn towards Allah. Hajjaj says, Hawwiluhu anil Qibla. Turn the wicked man away from Qibla. So when they turn him away, he says, Aynama tuwallu fathamma wajuhullah. Wherever you turn me, my Allah is there. Hajjaj says, drop him on the earth. When they drop him on the earth, he says, Minha khalaqnakum, wa fiha nu'idukum, wa minha nukhrijukum taratan ukhra. From the sand we created you, to the sand we return you. Hajjaj said, slaughter this man. Ma ra'aytu rajulan ad'a minhu li ayatil Quran. I've never seen a human and a young man who understood Quran better than Sayyid ibn Jubayr. He lifted his hands. He said, Allah, I patiently persevere and happily accept this death, but I have a request, my Lord. Allahumma la tusallit al-hajjaj ala ahadin ba'di. Allah, let me be the last victim of Hajjaj. Allah, I think it's time you grab the hand of this tyrant. Allah, I think it's time you put an end and you seize him. Now a tyrant like Hajjaj, on the dua of a young man, look at what Allah does to him. Hajjaj then mercilessly kills this person. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal said, Wallahi laqad qutila Sa'id ibn Jubayrin wa ma ala al-ardi ahadun illa wa huwa muhtajun ila ilmi. The death of Sa'id is such, it is not mourned by his family or by the nation. This entire earth today mourns the death of this young man. And I guess even the angels share in our grief today. Wallah, once upon a time the young man was such, on his death the entire world mourned his death. Wallahi laqad qutila Sa'id ibn Jubayrin. After that, this tyrant only had misery in his life. Cutting a long story short, when he died, someone seen him in a dream. They said, Hajjaj, how did you fare before Allah? He said, قَتَلَنِي بِكُلِّ قَتِيلٍ قَتَلْتُهُ قَتْلَةً وَقَتَلَنِي بِسَعِيدِ بْنِ جُبَيْرٍ سَبْعِينَ قَتْلًا. In lieu of every life I claimed, my Allah made me taste the agony of death once. But when I interfered with Sa'id ibn Jubayr, Allah said, you'll die 70 times. Understand the talent of the youth.
We are people of success, and this religion is a deen of success. It's not a deen of failure. And the Prophet was the most successful human being that ever lived on the face of the earth. And this is by the shahada of the non-Muslims. If you read Michael Hart, the historian who wrote the 100 most important personalities in history, he said the most successful human being that's ever lived is the Messenger of Allah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No one was more successful than the Messenger of Allah. وَلَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. And you have in him the best model, because he is the model and the mentor of success. And if we follow him, we have success.